Welcome to the Mint Report, our wrap of the day's business news. Here are the top stories. Kapil Sibal announces new telecom rules. PMO says Coal India will sign fuel supply agreements. And markets shoot up for a third straight day. First up, the government has indicated it will overhaul India's telecom rules and make them more market-friendly. On Wednesday, Telecom Minister Kapil Sibal unveiled new rules for licenses, spectrum and mergers. Most significantly, the new policy removes the link between spectrum and licenses. All telecom licenses will now be so-called unified licenses, and operators with licenses will have to get spectrum separately. There will also be a uniform license fee of 8%. Sibal also announced the government's intention to make mergers and acquisition easier. He said mergers that had a market share of up to 35% would be approved through a simple process. Wednesday's announcement comes soon after the Supreme Court scrapped 122 telecom licenses. In other news, the Prime Minister's office has stepped in to resolve the fuel crisis in India's power industry. On Wednesday, the PMO said government-run Coal India would sign fuel supply agreements with power companies. The move is meant to provide fuel for about 50,000 megawatts worth of generating capacity. Also, Coal India will have only until March end to sign agreements with power projects that have been up and running since the end of 2011. Of course, the PMO's announcement comes even as Coal India is expected to miss its own target for fuel supply. And finally, Indian markets have risen for a third straight session, beating all the gloomy predictions. The Sensex rocketed up 354 points to 18,202 and the Nifty rose 114 to 5,532. Wednesday's gains were led by sectors that benefit most from a fall in interest rates, and low inflation figures from the previous day heightened expectations of a rate cut. Starting with banks, India's biggest lender SBI jumped up 2.37% on the BSE to 2,250, and HDFC Bank shot up 3% to 533, while ICICI Bank beat them all with a gain of 4% to 980. Auto stocks also shot up in hopes of a monetary easing. Maruti Suzuki accelerated ahead 3% to 1,304, and Tata Motors raced past it with a 6.91% gain. But Mahindra & Mahindra trailed behind with a gain of just 2.57%. And that's all we have for you. Thanks for watching.